Good morning, boys and girls. Please stand for prayer. Okay, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now let's do the Pledge of Allegiance. Put your right hand over your heart. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And let's sing God Bless America. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet home. Good job, because that's how we're going to do it on our graduation day. Now let's do calendar. We're not going to do that on our graduation day, though. If yesterday was Tuesday, today is, that's right, Wednesday. If today's Wednesday, tomorrow will be, right, Thursday. If yesterday was June 9th, today is, right, June 10th. So we had a number with a 9 digit in the ones place, and now we have a group of 10. Repeat after me. Today is Wednesday, June 10th, 2020. En español, hoy es el miércoles 10 de junio 2020. Very good. And today we are on our 172nd day of learning. That's 100 plus 72. So the cardinal number is 172. But as an ordinal number, we say 172nd. Okay, we're going to skip count again. So we've been practicing skip counting by 10. We practice skip counting by 5s. Today we're going to skip count by 2s. So if things are in pairs, in sets of 2, we can skip count by 2s. So let's look at the number chart first. And since we're skip counting by 2, we're going to skip number 1 and we're going to go right to number 2. So 2, and then we're going to skip 3 and go right to 4. And then we're going to skip right 5, and where will we land? At 6. We're going to skip 7 and hop to 8. Okay, that's why we call it skip counting. We are skipping a number in between. We're going to skip 9 and hop to 10. Okay, so let's say the row that we have right now. Skip counting by 2. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Let's do it again. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay, we're going to continue. So 10 was our last one we said. We're going to skip 11, and now we are at 12. Okay, we're going to skip 13, and now we're at, right, 14. We're going to skip 14, and now we are at 16. We're going to skip 17, and now we're at Right, 18. We're going to skip 19 and hop over to the 20. Okay, let's take a look at what we have now. Do you see a pattern forming? Right, you should. Because both of these numbers have a 2-digit in the ones place. Both of these have a 4-digit in the ones place. Both of these have a 6-digit in the ones place. Both of these have an 8, and both of these have a 0. So let's take it from the top. Ready? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Let's go to this row. What number do you think will be next? I'm not going to use my little hopper now because you can see the pattern. Right, 22. Then what? Right, 24. So you're saying a pattern of 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10 every time, except you're saying a different number because they will all have the same digits in the ones place. So 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, right? Because 30 is 3 groups of 10. Okay, let's go to the next row. What will we circle next? Right, 32, because there's a 2 in the ones place. So 32, 34. What's next? 36, 38, and then 40, 4 groups of 10. Let's go to the next row, ready? 42, 44, saying it with me, 46, that's how you get good at it, 48, and 50. Okay, good, let's go to the next row. What are we going to do, 51? No, it doesn't have a 2 in it. 52, 54, 56, 58, and then 60, which is 6 groups of 10. A bug flew in my eye. Okay, next row, 62, 64, 66, 68, 70. Next row. Now we're in the 70s, so it's going to be the pattern of 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Ready? 72, 74, 76, 78, and then 80. 8 groups of 10. Okay, next row. Now we're in the 80s, and we have to do a 2, 4, 6, 8 with all of them. Ready? 82, 84, 86, 88, and then 90. That is 9 groups of 10. Okay, last row. 92, 94, 96, 98, and 100. So, the pattern here is that the 2, 4, 6, 8, and the 0 are repeating over and over again. We just pick up another group of 10 in each row. Now, can you count all things by 2s? No. But if you have a group of things and you sort them, you can drag 2, 4, 6, 8 until as long as they're in pairs of 2. You can keep counting by 2s. So what kind of things could we count by 2s? What type of things come in pairs? Right, mittens come in pairs. Good shoes come in pairs. And actually, if we were at school, I would have you all take off your shoes and we would count them by 2s. Okay. And socks. Okay. Well, that's what I have here. Socks. And you see I have the numbers on them. So, if I want to know how many socks I have, as long as they're in pairs, I can count them by 2s. So what I'm going to do, and you're going to help me, is, and they are in pairs, yes? They will have a partner, a match. Okay, so I don't have to go 1, 2. I can just go like this. 2, 4, 6, bring these guys up here, 8, 10, actually I have it up there, you can see the rows, 10, okay, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, because there's 2 socks in each set. Okay, the pattern continues now. It needs to have a 2, so 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Okay, let's check it out. These both have a 2, yes? These both have a 4. These both have a 6. These both have an 8. And these both have a 0 because they're both sets of 10. Okay, so if I didn't have, let me grab one. Can I count these by 2s? No, because I can count one set, 2. This is not a pair, so it's 3. Okay, so things that are in pairs, or when you're counting and you pull them into pairs, actually we're going to keep that here, we can count by 2s. Now, there's something else about these numbers. Because they are in sets, we call those even numbers. Even because they have an even, each have a partner, right? So we're going to do an activity with that now. I have a bunch of socks. Okay, so I feel like I'm hanging laundry for you. And first, we'll put them up and then we'll see if we can count them by 2s. Okay, why don't you count as I put them up? How many is that? It's a pair. So, 2. How many is that? 4. This is something you can practice at home, too, because you have socks. It's a pair, right? Okay. So how many is that? Like those socks, Julia? I think you gave them to me for Christmas. I don't want to hang. Okay, so there's 2 there. What's next? 2, 4. Right, 6. Can I count these by 2? What's next? 7? No, because it's 2. 8. 2, 4, 6, 8. Can I count these? How many? 10. Good. It's a pair, right? So we can keep counting by 2s. 10. Okay, so now we've got to repeat the pattern with the 2. I don't know how low I can go so you can see. Almost 1. So what number now? It has to have a 2, right? It's a pair. 12. Let's see, 12. Oh. It's a pair. We can count them by 2. So the next number has to have a 4 in it. So what will it be after 12? We're going to skip 13 and go to 14. Good. Okay, let's see if I have another pair. I do. So what are we going to go to? It has to have a 6. So what is it? After 14, we're going to skip 15. Good. And go to 16. I have another pair. I do. So we can keep counting by 2. So the next one has to have an 8. So what number has 8 after 16? Right, 18. We're going to skip 17, and we're going to go to 18. Hey, I'm going to mess up our count. Stay with your partner. And, look at that. One more set. So, do we put our 18? No, we do not. 18. Now, the next one has to have a zero digit. So, after 18, what will we skip? We're going to skip 19 and go to 20. Good.
Door here.
20. Okay. So, because they are all in sets of two, we can count them by two. So, let's do it. We want to know how many socks we have all together, not how many pairs of socks, how many actual socks. And since they were in pairs, sets of two, we can count by two. So let's do it. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Okay, so today in your book, you're going to do a similar activity with the chart. Counting by twos today. You can use your highlighter to color the way I circled on my chart, unless you were doing it with me, you have half your page done. Okay, the other thing we're going to work on are odd and even. Now, even, right? You might have heard the term even Steven. Okay, that kind of means equal. Okay, remember when we were doing equalizing? When we did one-to-one correspondence to show that each one gets one. So you were forming pairs there. And, or if the set was not even, you made them even. Okay, so we're going to do something similar to that. We talk about numbers that are odd and even. So all of these numbers, any number counting by twos, are even numbers, which makes then the other numbers odd. So any number that's not circled is an odd number. Right? Not odd like strange, but odd. So I'm going to circle the odd ones in green. For example, let me show you. If I have some cubes here, and I want to see if they are an odd number or an even number. The way I can find out is if I set them in pairs. I'm going to separate them and give each one a partner. Okay, so there's a set of two, so they're partners. Okay, I can take off another set of two and they're partners. Okay, but look, he doesn't have a partner. So we would say that five is an odd number, okay? So one is an odd number because it doesn't have a partner. And you can try this with your cubes at home. Okay, if we have three cubes, one doesn't have a partner. So three is an odd number. Okay, see, two has a partner. Four, if you separate them, is two sets of two. They're even numbers. Okay, five, we said, did not have a partner. And let's see if seven is odd or even. Okay, so here I have a group of seven. I'm going to see if they all get a partner. Okay, I took two off, so he has a partner. Two more off. There's a partner. Two more off. Oh, but I have one by itself. It does not have a partner. So seven, then, is an odd number. Okay? Let's try nine. Okay. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Nope, I just want nine. Okay. So I have a set of nine. I'm going to see if it's odd or even. I'm going to take two off. They're a pair. They have a partner. Two more off. They're a partner. Two more off. They have a partner. Two more off. Oh, but this guy is the odd man out. He doesn't have a partner. So nine is an odd number. Do you see a pattern here? Right. odd, even, odd, even, odd, even, odd, even. So if you understand that your even numbers are all of the numbers when we count 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, then you'll know that all of the other numbers are odd. Okay, another way you can practice at home is maybe get, after mom does the laundry, and you can help her roll the socks too when you're done. Okay, after mom does the laundry, you can get a bunch of socks before they're rolled, right? Because they don't have their partners yet. And you can lay them out to find partners. And sometimes I know that when I was a kid helping mom roll the socks, we used to play a game called Go Sock, like Go Fish. Do you have one of these? We often found odd socks. Not odd as in strange, but odd as in socks that didn't have a partner. So, what I'm doing right now is something you can do at home to see if you have any odd socks without a partner. And when you count them up by twos, you'll see that if it comes up as an odd number, you have a sock without a partner. Okay, so here I have a bunch of socks. Okay, let's count and see if we have any odd. Let's match them up. Okay, so here I have a pair. So that is two. That's a set. These two are a pair. These two have a pair. They're even, because two is an even number. So right now I have two, four, six, and they all have pairs, so six is an even number, not an odd number. Okay. There's a pair. Do you see a partner for him? No. So he is an odd sock. He does not have a partner. So if we were counting 2, 4, 6, 8, then one more 9. 9 is an odd number because one of them does not have a partner. Okay, so what you're going to practice today is skip counting by twos and finding the odd and even numbers. So here on the top, they did it with cubes. You can practice that at home too. Then on the bottom, the leaves on a branch. 2. So you count by 2. Then the next row, 2, 4. 2, 4, 6. You're counting up by twos. 2, 4, 6, 8. Who do we appreciate? Kindergarten. Kindergarten. And then you write the 8. On the other side is just like what I did here. Okay, you can use your highlighter. You don't have to use the color they tell you. Okay? But when you do it, don't just take your highlighter and, okay, I see the pattern. Now I'm going to color the whole row. Because then are you really skip counting? Are you practicing? No. You're going fast to get done. You want to do it so you can learn. So, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Go to the next row. It has to have a 2, right? 12, 14, 16. Okay, that's the correct way to do it, okay? And then on the other page that you're going to do, it's just like I showed you with the odd socks and the odd cubes. Okay, they're going to show a number. I'll do an example for you. They're going to give you a number. So let's say we have the number 5. And they want you to make 5 blocks. But when you make it, you should make it in pairs so you can see if it has a partner. If it doesn't have a partner, it's going to be an odd number. So if we have the number 5, and I have to make 5 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, is that an odd or even number? Okay, well, there's a pair, and there's a pair, but he does not have a partner. So 5 then is what? An odd number. So on your paper, it says odd. Odd starts with O, even starts with E. Is 5 odd or even? It's only even if everybody gets a pair. Everybody doesn't have pairs, so 5 is odd. another. And this time I might see the 8. And you're going to draw to show, try and show pairs. So if you draw it nice and straight, it'll be easier for you to see. We're making 8 boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, let's write our words. Odd, even. Okay, now let's see if they all have a pair. Okay, there's a pair, there's a pair, there's a pair, and there's a pair. So each set has a pair. Okay, so is it odd or even? Right, you will circle the word even. Okay, so you're going to do the page like that, and then there will be also on Seesaw a skip counting by 2 page, okay? So you're going to do 2 pages in your book, and then an activity on Seesaw. And this is the only video lesson that you're having today, but there will be practice pages scanned to your parents again for reading, practicing the skills that you've learned, and on Seesaw. Okay, now we're going to end with our prayer, our guardian angel prayer, because that'll be the last thing we do in our graduation day. Ready? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits me here, ever this day be at my side, to light and guard, to rule and guide. Dear God, please help all the sick people get well. Please help all the children who don't have a family. And please help me do the best that I can to be like Jesus. And may we all see each other again really soon. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'll see you all again at 2 o'clock. I hope you practiced your songs and your prayers. And I'm going to give your parents your sentence. Okay. See you at 2 o'clock.